Good day and welcome to Flash and Times TV News Hour. I am Debra Houdini. Now let's dive into today's stories. Minimum wage. Senators' reps should also hand 62,000 naira. And board pledges to uphold transparency calls for government support. Premier Pilgrim from Nigeria commits site in Medina. Kano Anti-Graft Agency investigates alleged scam in street workers environment scheme. Now the news in details. Senators' reps should also hand 62,000 naira. Ejike Mbaka, the spiritual leader, the spiritual director of Adoration Ministry in Enugu, has stirred controversy by suggesting that members of the National Assembly should also earn the proposed of 62,000 naira minimum wage. His remarks also came in response to the federal government's proposal police strike declared by the Nigerian Labour Congress (NLC) and Trade Union Congress (TUC) in an interview with Africa Independent Television (AIT). Mbaka criticized the current wage disparity between ordinary Nigerian workers and political office holders. He urged that the nation's leaders should share in the economic realities by the average citizen. Mbaka called for a uniform salary structure, proposing that if the minimum wage is set at 62,000 naira, this amount should also apply to governors, senators, and members of the House of Representatives. The spiritual leader described the exorbitant allowances collected by lawmakers, including sitting allowances, wardrobe allowances, newspaper allowances, vehicle allowances, and even suffering allowances. Mbaka also spotlighted the financial struggles of essential workers, such as teachers, nurses, and doctors, who often work long hours for minimal pay. And board pledges to uphold transparency calls for government support. In a bid to foster integrity and professional excellence within the media industry, Alhaji Abdulrazak Abdulghani, the president of the Association of Nigerian Broadcaster and Board, has committed to upholding transparency and ethical standards. This pledge was made during a Thanksgiving service held at the African Solution Camp in Hewan Estate, Abeokuta, Ogun State, to celebrate the successful completion of recent national and state elections. Addressing the congregation, Abdulghani emphasized the association's dedication to fulfilling its constitutional duties both under the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the internal guidelines of Canboard. In a speech, Abdulghani called on the government to support the media's role in society by allowing journalists to operate without undue restrictions. He stressed the importance of media freedom in ensuring that professionals can report accurately and responsibly. The Bishop of the African Church, Reverend Jeremiah Okunlola, who was also present at the service, echoed Abdulghani's sentiments. He urged ANBOD members to remain truthful and committed to their professional duties. The event also served as a reminder of the recent elections within ANBOD, which also saw the election of its first of national leaders, Alhaji Abdulrazak Abdulghani, known widely as Mr. GRK, was elected as the inaugural president of the association. Alongside him, the renewed Abeokuta broadcaster Akinyemi Olatoye, popularly referred to as Alawiye Federation, was chosen as the vice president. The newly elected leaders have expressed their commitment to advancing the standards of broadcasting in Nigeria with a focus to transparency, professionalism, and public service. Female Pilgrim from Nigeria commits suicide in Medina. The Kwara State Muslims Pilgrims Board announced on Sunday that a female pilgrim from Nigeria has committed suicide in Medina. According to Saudi Arabian authorities, the incident involved a pilgrim named Ajia Awawu was reportedly jumped from the rooftop of her apartment. The tragic news was confirmed by Abdulsalam Abdulkabir, the executive secretary of the Kwara State Muslims Pilgrims Board, in a press release. Abdulkabir also disclosed that another pilgrim from the state, Salih Muhammad, passed away in Medina. According to the state's release, Salih Muhammad fell ill suddenly and was admitted to the intensive care unit of a public hospital in Medina, where he later died. Kwara State Muslim Pilgrims Board sent heartfelt commemorations to the families of two of our pilgrims who returned to the Lord in Medina, Saudi Arabia. The death of Hajia Hawawu and Sayu Muhammad have added to the growing list of Nigerian pilgrims who have died in Saudi Arabia ahead of this year's Hajj, which is set to begin on Friday. As preparations for the Hajj continue, the recent spread of death has cast a shadow over the pilgrimage, prompting calls for heightened attention to the welfare and health of pilgrims. The Saudi authorities, along with Nigeria officials, are expected to take additional measures to ensure the safety and well-being of all pilgrims during this holy period. Kano Anti-Graft Agency investigates alleged scam in Street Hawkers Empowerment Scheme. The Kano State Public Compliance and Anti-Corruption Commission has initiated an investigation into an alleged scam with the recently launched Street Hawkers Empowerment Scheme by the Kano State Government. The scheme, designed to provide financial support to street hawkers, has been tainted by allegations of fraud, prompting a dispute brought by the Commission. The scheme, inaugurated last Wednesday, aimed to empower 465 street hawkers with a grant of 50,000 naira each. However, viral videos surfaced showing a group of youth who were not part of the official beneficiary list, allegedly impersonating the legitimate recipients. According to reports, these impersonators managed to collect the 50,000 naira grants, but were being coerced by an intermediary who took 45,000 naira from each, leaving them with only 5,000 naira. Barrister Oyo Magaji Inigando, the chairman of the Kano State Public Compliance and Anti-Corruption Commission, confirmed that the commission has begun investigation about the allegations. He emphasized the commission's commitment to bringing the perpetrators to justice and safeguarding the integrity of the empowerment schemes. He assured the public that the agency's activities are not aimed at witch hunting, but as ensuring accountability and transparency in government schemes. He cited ongoing investigations into activities from both the past and present administrations, including the case of the suspended managing director of Abubakar Rimi Television, who is currently facing court proceedings over alleged misappropriation of funds. And that will be all for today's On News Power on Platinum Times TV. Kindly visit our website on www.platinumtimes.com.ng for more exclusive stories. Good afternoon and bye for now.